We can't solve all of the world's problems alone. We need to be working with other countries. We need their cooperation. We need their partnership. But also confidence, because America, at its best, still has a greater ability than any other country on Earth to bring others together to meet the challenges of our time. And that's where the men and women of the State Department, Foreign Service officers, civil servants, that's where they come in.
Let's speak to Scott Lucas, Professor of International Politics at the University of Birmingham here in the UK. Scott, good to see you. It's a very diverse cabinet, isn't it? Female Treasury Secretary, we're expecting the Latino heading up Homeland Security. He's announced a female Director of National Intelligence. This is clearly very different to how Trump's administration looked. What do you make of it?
The adults are back in the room. And by that, I mean you've got choices for national security and foreign policy who have experience, who've been involved in decades in the U.S. government at the highest levels, the National Security Council, the CIA, the State Department. And the words that you heard today that John Brain were talking about was hitting the notes of America is back, diplomacy is back, multilateralism is back. In other words, engaging with countries in terms of trying to find common interests, trying to find a way forward on issues, rather than a foreign policy, which, to be honest with you, starts with one man's ego and one man's Twitter feed. Now, that doesn't mean there won't be issues, significant issues, between America and a number of countries, including Turkey. But it means that the people there will play by the rules of the game. The one thing you don't want in international diplomacy and that you don't want in foreign policy is unpredictability. And you do not want that unpredictability to be combined with chaos. And what you're getting is a fairly steady group of people, even before we know who the defense secretary is, that I think you're looking at someone in Joe Biden who's talking now about a Biden team, a collective group, not just simply one man and a few of his family and friends around him.
But as Joe Biden forges ahead with transition, you know, in the background, you've got a president who still hasn't conceded defeat, is still talking about legal challenges. Is that a confusing message for the American public?
It's not just confusing, it's damaging and it's potentially destructive. And we have to realize that Donald Trump, reluctantly accepting the transition, is only one step forward, and he'll try to pull two steps back within the next 24 hours with these tweets, which are about disinformation, which are about conspiracy theories, which are all about the fact that the election is stolen, probably setting up the idea that he'll say, I'm going to run for president in 2024 to take back what is rightfully mine. Now, that message will reinforce some people who are dug in with Trump, who think that the man cannot do any wrong. And right now what America needs in the middle of a pandemic is it needs unity, it needs cooperation, it needs dialogue rather than division. But Trump doesn't want that. And the second problem, beyond his rhetoric and disinformation, is that he has 2 months as president where he can do a lot of damage through executive orders. He could do a lot of damage regarding immigration, the environment, healthcare, and indeed foreign relations just by signing a piece of paper. And he will do it because he is committed to making Joe Biden's life as difficult as possible before and after Inauguration Day on January 20th.
Scott, thank you. Scott Lucas speaking to us live there.